Hello, Achron fans, and welcome to this exhibition match between Shadowfury333 and Kytin. I'm your host, Shadowfury333, and we're on Rooftop Showdown. This is a brand new map that just came out. It came out just a bit after the patch, so it's not included in that patch, but it is on the mod browser. You can download it from there. It's a two-player map, some of a smaller map than a lot of other maps. It's fairly wide, not super tall, and it's got a perfectly straight line between the two bases, so it feels kind of small despite its size. There's also expansions along the center and top and bottom of each side for each player, basically natural expansions. And this is also on version 1.2, which I've already made a video for regarding the changes. So if you were curious about why this seems so different, why the resourcing rate's different, and all these other things, you can watch that video. Anyway, so we see Shadowfury is going for very quick, lots of LC, though getting a UPRP as well. Kytin on the other hand, sorry, is a few moves behind that. Sorry, I was playing Vecgir on this as well. The economy changes, I'm happy to point out that I mentioned, seem to be working quite well in making the game a lot more fun to play. And I'm saying this as playing as Vecgir, because he's the player who basically started properly doing macro-oriented play in Achron, so that's saying something. Anyway, so Kytin setting up his RPs, four on LC and one on QP. He's trying very hard to get this exactly right. I'm not sure exactly why he's so. He's getting one octave here. I don't know why he is trying to redo these orders so often. Anyway, Shadowfury going into the future, getting very quick auto defense about 3 minute mark, and getting lots and lots of. He's getting tons of RPs right now. So going very heavily for economy, really trying to push that economy, figure out how far it can go with the new system. While Kytin hasn't really been building a whole lot of economy. He's building up quick Octopod, though. And this is something he's been actually liking doing a lot, is building Octopods very early on and using them to attack. Which, of course, is going to leave Shadowfury in a bit of a bad spot, because Shadowfury is going for a heavily economic-oriented build, and Octopods do a great job of countering that. So, Shadowfury now setting up his depot at the 426 mark, and Kytin is getting his Octopod towards Shadowfury's base. He is attacking at the 129 mark. This is before Shadowfury even sets up his first foundation for that depot. Like I said, he's going very, very heavily economy, and Kytin is going more for... he's going for economy now, but he's going more for aggression early on, getting this early Octopod and now sending it in. So it should be hitting about the 3 minute mark, which is basically when the depot came in. Actually, no, faster than that. Be hitting about the 240 mark, I'd say. And that is going to be a bit of a problem for Shadowfury. Shadowfury does have, at this point, he hasn't been sending out any Zyanvirs anymore, but he does have Zyanvirs just building RPs. And here comes the Octopod at 245 mark, hitting the base. It is going to be attacking the Zyanvir, and no depot even yet. So Shadowfury jumping back, try to see what's going on here. Sees the Octopod coming in. Can't really do anything about it at the moment. He doesn't have... He's getting auto-defense upgrades, so he can't build any foundations. But he is trying... He's going to be obviously trying to build a foundation as soon as he can. There we go. Foundation being built up. Auto-defense, of course, exists, so he will be able to turn it into a Bastion as soon as he gets the chance. And he is doing exactly that. So turning it into a Bastion, while Kytin is continuing to build up his economy, he is slightly ahead of this, actually. But he has his Reef coming up as well, so he can get his own tech very quickly. And starting to get his economy built up, he has an Octo going towards the south base as well. Or a couple Octos sent towards the south base. Octopod is fighting the foundation. And Shadowfury does seem to be able to defend this base, but he is pushing very hard. Kytin's pushing very hard. Shadowfury is having a very hard time actually pushing with the Octopod, losing the Bastion in the process. And the Octopod is going to be going down. But it's still a hard-fought battle for Shadowfury. And he is down resources compared to what he would have wanted. However, being that he's ahead in economy, he still has a bit of an advantage over Kytin at this point. Kytin is at the 440 mark. He is getting... he isn't getting a tech yet. He's getting more RPs towards the south base. His main base, he has what he wants. And he's getting advanced structures. There we go, getting his tech. And jumping back to the 4 minute mark, just double checking what he has. It looks like he's going, trying to figure out what he can do better with his Octopod when he gets the chance. Seeing this Bastion here. And at the 247 mark, he is going back and he is actually walking towards... He is walking to block the foundation. It looks like he is, in fact, going to be blocking this foundation So Shadowfury will be unable to build that. Not saying that, of course, Shadowfury doesn't notice this is happening. Kytin has just jumped away from that, so it won't propagate until the next this green time wave comes along. And Shadowfury, of course, in the future, thinking that everything's all well and good, building Zion Turtles to start harassing and getting some counter-pushing going, getting the north base built up, getting the south base a bit built up, not much going on there. And Kytin at this point hadn't really built too much. Kytin's about 30 seconds down from here. He is getting a second reef. Just to protect. Actually, no, he's getting a full bubble wrap. That's three reefs together to start healing each other, and, well, they're not quite close enough to heal each other, but still healing everything in the base. And now Shadowfury has jumped back and realizes the Octopod has actually blocked off. He has blocked off everything going on in the annex, so the annex can't actually build anything. There's no foundations that can be built because autofence is being upgraded. So, and of course, troops are being deployed. Shadowfury is going to have to try really hard to get this away from here. Kytin is about 2 minutes up from here. He is focused on just keeping this base down. There are units still being built. Shadowfury cannot build a foundation while there are units in the annex being built. So that's going to be very tough for him. Shadowfury is, at the future time, he is actually, or about 6 minutes in the game, this is a Zion Torture being sent to Kytin, but it's no point worrying about that. That Zion Torture will not exist ultimately. So Shadowfury is trying to stop this last troop deployment so we can at least build some units, build a foundation, build it in a different direction. And he has succeeded in doing this. He is going to be building a foundation towards the north, and that will be able to hold off this Octopod. Getting a Bastion there will actually be able to succeed in holding off the Octopod. Very close though. Kytin, of course, building up more units. He is in a pretty safe spot right now. He has put enough pressure on Shadowfury so that the economy that Shadowfury had does not ultimately help him out. And it looks like the Octopod is actually moving up, trying to block the expansion up there, the top right corner of the foundation, the annex, but that will not work. Sorry, to the foundation up there. However, that does stop a Bastion from existing, and Shadowfury is in a really bad spot right now. So Shadowfury finally getting that foundation to the southeast of the annex. Still able to build the foundations he needs to get rid of that Octopod, but very hard-fought battle, and Kytin has managed, in the meantime, not getting his north base, but getting his south base, and that's going to help him out a great deal. He can actually have the economy to push forward. He does have, like, he has tech, he has Aspire further in the future. He's going to be able to get, well, he's going to be able to get enough units that it's not going to be a big deal for him to just complete this push. So Shadowfury is going to be having a very hard time getting out of this. What we see now is not actually what's happening. The base was saved, ultimately. But Shadowfury does have to worry about all this, and is trying to make sure that he gets everything he can. He doesn't actually have as much economy as he would have liked, either. His RPs were slowed down by having to defend against the Octopod, and the Octopod, of course, wasn't really well defended against. The Bastions were okay, but the foundation got built so late, the Octopod managed to block it, which is a very clever move on Kytin's part. But still, that was scary for Shadowfury, I'm sure. And Pharos and Seppi's being built for Kytin. I'm not sure if he's going for a direct attack or if he's going for base. And it looks like he's going for a direct attack with the Seppi's and Pharos. And jumping back to the 547 mark, we see a Zion Pulsar from Shadowfury coming up to fight off the Octopod. By the way, Zion Pulsars actually lose in a straight-up fight against Octopods, but this Octopod was weakened first. So it's no surprise that it actually was a possibility. Anyway, the Octopod going into progen mode to regenerate its own health. And it doesn't look like Kytin has any air units yet, but he could, of course, get a Pharopod in there, start building Seppi Legos under Shadowfury's base. Though, from what I've been finding and playing in this version, Seppi Legos are not as powerful as they were in 1110, so they're counterable. It's not like it would be just this winning unit no matter what. It's a bit harder to use now, which is nice. Though I haven't seen him pushed as hard as they could be, so it's possible that it might not be as rebalanced as I hope, but it did seem to be balanced from what I was trying it myself. Anyway, the Seppi's and Pharos being sent to attack, they fended off the Zion Pulsar and now attacking the Zion, fended off the Zion Torture, now attacking the Zion Pulsar. The Zion Pulsar will be destroyed pretty quickly, but it does manage to destroy a couple Seppi's. Not that it matters, there aren't a lot of air units coming in yet for Shadowfury. He does have an aerial control center, but he's not focused on air units yet, mostly focused on ground, anti-ground, Zion Torture, Zion Pulsars. Kytin is back about half a minute, seeing the attack going on, and Shadowfury probably trying to avoid the attack, but he doesn't. There's an Octo actually down here as well, in case Shadowfury wanted to go down towards the natural expansion and work from there. The Zion Torture is managing to get in through Kytan's forces, but looks like Kytin does see that coming, so he's going to block it off, make sure it does not come in, try to destroy it before it gets in, and going back to attack it to stop it from actually doing any harassment. So Shadowfury will be unable to actually harass Kytan's base. Kytin does have a lot of resources too. He's going to be able to very quickly get chronoporting. I'm sure he's going to get chronoporting any minute now. And yes, enabling chronoporting technology. So he is getting chronoporting a bit later on. Not when we see now. He jumped back slightly. And he now is getting chronoporting at the 732 mark. And jumping back, both players are jumping back near the unplayable past, trying to make sure that the Zion Torture, well, basically tug of war around the Zion Torture. Shadowfury trying to get the Zion Torture around the natural expansion, while Kytin is trying to stop anything from going through. But Kytin has, whoa, where does, Kytin's units are not even really defending the front of the base anymore. They pulled back slightly and now going towards the north, so Shadowfury actually has an opening to get in, and he's taking advantage of this opening. And it's hard to tell what's going to happen with it. He has jumped back, or jumped forward slightly. But from Kytin's point of view, we see that Shadowfury is managing to deal some damage, but not a whole lot. That attack was not as well planned as it could have been. It should have moved in further and then started attacking the Triad. But now Kytin has the chance to get his base class units in to destroy the Zion Torture and Zion Pulsar that attacked. So that was a wasted opportunity. And an Octopod, Kytin actually has an Octopod, the one that was healing down here with progen mode. Now just hanging out here, probably waiting in chronoport. Going for that attack will be very devastating if he goes for it. It's, of course, this is why Shadowfury hasn't managed to expand down to the south base, because he doesn't have, well, the Octopod was there for a while, couldn't get through. And now Kytin's paused, he's likely to chronoport something, like I said, probably this Octopod, and we will see what goes on in a second. The Octopod has been chronoported back, and it is going to be attacking Shadowfury in the unplayable path, so Shadowfury now has to deal with this UPP attack from the Octopod, and that's going to be very scary. That's right on his resources, and he's, like I said, even though he went for an economy build early on, he is having a very hard time actually dealing with this, and there's pretty much no way, nothing, no time he has that he can actually start attacking that Octopod. Which is unfortunate, which means that Octopod's going to be dealing a ton of damage to Shadowfury's main base, and Shadowfury really only has the main base and sort of the north base, but not much else. The south base he never expanded to, and his main base, even that's not getting him enough resources to really get a huge army. So Kytin is at a massive advantage, even though both he only has as many bases as Shadowfury, he has managed to keep his units alive longer and make better use of them, also using a lot of base class units. Shadowfury has a massive army at the 10-minute mark, but I don't see it being very useful just because there's a lot of stuff going on in the unplayable past that's going to stop him from actually building that army in the first place. I mean, from Kytin's point of view, at the 9:40 mark, Shin Turtle's coming in to help attack. Pharopod actually going in towards Shadowfury's base, but Kytin jumping away from that to stop propagating it. No, never mind, he is just going back to double-check the attack. The Pharopod has continued along into the base, so the Pharopod is not helping out defend. Wow, that Shin Churcher dealing a ton of damage to the Pharos. So the Pharos are not having any luck getting rid of the Shin Churcher. But Sepipod's coming in to deal with it will have no problem destroying it. A couple Zion Pulses as well coming in, but that's going to be moved away. And Shadowfury not yet having to deal with this Octopod in the past, but he is going to see it now. See this red here? That is the Octopod attacking these RPs. Destroying all of those RPs and really reducing the amount of... Okay, Shadowfury I think realizes this already. And he's building a slipgate, trying to make sure that he gets chronoport units back, but he doesn't have a lot of QP left to actually chronoport his units. I don't see this working out very well for him at all. Kytin, however, Kytin is only in this one base. He only has this one triad. He only has these RPs. Shadowfury, if he pushes the economic advantage and avoids these chronoports as well, he could have a chance, but it's going to be very difficult for him to do that, and he doesn't have a lot of resources invested in this. And Shadowfury is actually at the present. He has chronoported back a ton of units, but I don't see that being very useful. He didn't chronoport back very many units. Teleporting the rest of them into Kytin's base near the present, but that's not going to be very useful at this point. And we see that the units have chronoported back on the red time wave. Shin Churcher's coming in, but the Octopod still hasn't been stopped. The Octopod's still in the main base. The Shin Churcher's going towards Kytin's base rather slowly too. They're hierarchied with that Zion Pulsar probably. Zion Pulsar going back to destroy the Octopod, and it might be able to destroy it. I kind of doubt, though, like I said before, the Octopods will win against Zion Pulsars in a straight fight. And now Kytin is chronoporting back something else likely. He has paused, probably that Pharopod. And yes, the Pharopod has been chronoported back to attack even harder, so Shadowfury really doesn't have much of a chance at this point. He is moving with the Shin Churchers, though. He is dealing quite a bit of damage, but of course the Sepipods destroy Shin Churchers. Shin Churchers can't do anything about air units. They can in large groups, but like I said, the Shin Churchers are still falling very quickly to the Sepipods. Sepipods are anti-air units, and Shadowfury has GG'd. Maybe a bit prematurely, but he did lose his economy in his main base, and he was getting Pharopod attacked everywhere else. So, anyway, that was a bit anticlimactic, but yeah, that was Rooftop Showdown. Interesting map, and it was an odd game. A lot of chronoporting, a lot of shenanigans going on from Kytin's side, but Shadowfury really did not take full advantage of the economy start that he had. Even with his north base here, he didn't take full advantage of it. So it's kind of unfortunate, but hopefully with some practice you'll be getting better. And Kytin, well done to him. So that was the game. Thank you for watching and have a good night.